This is a special video because I can't reshoot this. I don't have a screen recorder and I'm going to format my phone with you, which means if I make a mistake on this video, I can't shoot it again. Hello there, uncles and aunties. I'm in Mumbai currently, but I was holidaying in Goa last week when I thought about this. What would happen if you lost your phone in the ocean or something like that? What would you do about your data if you lost your phone suddenly? So I'm gonna pretend I lost my phone now and I'll just factory reset it with you guys. Then I'll show you how I'll restore that data back. For the purpose of this video, I'll divide the kind of data into two. One would be the auto update part, the part where it updates by itself, and one would be the non-auto update part. Back in the day, this used to take me like a day or two aside to back up everything, to research how to do it first, back up everything, and then to format my phone. But today I'm just going with the gun and doing it right in front of you guys. All right, so let's do this. I'll just go to settings, look for factory reset. There it is. Erase all data, factory reset. Don't really want to do this, but it has to look like an emergency. So I'll go ahead and there, it's done. Finally, here we are. Can't see a thing. I think we'll just go inside. Okay, so it's on. Everything that I set up on my phone according to my preferences is off. First of all, it vibrates when I press it. I don't like that. NFC is on. Let's just set the phone up. So as you can see, Google is offering to copy stuff from my previous usage. I'll just hit next. I'll sign into my account because that's how they know who I am. Oh, there was a backup yesterday at 10:26 p.m. I didn't do that, just to make that clear. All right, so I obviously want all the contacts back. Call history is just 200 kilobytes. Wi-Fi settings and all of this stuff is the clouds part, and you can choose which apps you want from the whole list. Alright, so I'm back home. I'll just connect this to the Wi-Fi. There, it's connected. The good thing is it already had my Wi-Fi password. I just had to get home. That's awesome. But yeah, now it's downloading my contacts. That's a lot of my contacts. I'll just give it a second and see all the stuff that it's gonna download. Looks like it's downloaded some of the apps. I'm just gonna set. So there you have it. Everything is ready. I just need to pick up all those important apps that I had over here. Need to set up my phone on that front. The dark theme is back. Apart from that, here are all the apps that I just downloaded. And my WhatsApp is almost... There you go. My WhatsApp is almost done. It's waiting for Wi-Fi. But I think it'll be done in the next couple of hours. I just wanted to finish the video. And that's it. That's all my stuff. I thought I'll get this over with in the morning itself, but my phone took forever to do that initial part because our Wi-Fi is slow. But it's finally here. I've completed that reinitializing my phone part. Assuming that this was a new phone, I've installed all my apps. It was easy, just time consuming because of the Wi-Fi, but it was easy because I was not doing anything. And my WhatsApp is installed as well with all the messages and the media that I used to have back then. if you're facing troubles with storage, your phone is running out of storage, or your battery is draining too frequently, or your phone is overheating, I left an asterisk on these two guys because there's a myriad of other problems that can be causing them. If you're facing any of these three problems, then doing this exercise that we just did today can be helpful. Can you see clearly? Doing this exercise can be useful. When you have problems like these, you can classify the reason for these problems into a software issue or a hardware issue. Now, he doesn't want me to shoot. He's like, who the hell are you?
Yeah, bhai.
Bhagna. So as I was saying, the problem could either be software or hardware. Now I'm counting storage, full storage, as a software problem, all right? So if you do this exercise that we just did, it gets rid of all the possibility of the software being wonky, you know? And then it's just probably a hardware problem. Either your phone has too small a storage for your demands, or you need to get a new battery because it's worn out, or it could be a myriad of other problems. There you have it. If I happen to lose my phone by some accident and I can't track it back by all those methods that I spoke to you guys about before, then my data, the most important data, is still safe, and that's what's important. That's it for this video, guys. I encourage you guys to go ahead and give it a try. Do a backup and factory reset on your phone. That'll help you understand which is the important data for you, and it'll help you manage your own data by yourself. You know, once you do this advanced maneuver, then there's nothing really standing between you and your data anymore. You know, using the cloud storage, you don't ever have to go back to saving the contacts one by one or looking for all the photos that you've ever shot on your phone. I hope that video was helpful, guys. I hope you never lose your phone. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.